Some Long Island commuters are worried it won't be such a smooth ride tomorrow. CBS 2's Weijia Jiang live tonight in Massapequa for us. Weijia?
And Massapequa got the worst of it here on Nassau County. Why all the schools, including this one, will be operating on a two-hour delay, giving crews time to clear up the snow and the ice you see here all around it. And this is exactly what will slow down so many people tomorrow. The storm skipped town as quickly as it slammed Long Island, leaving a mess that could last for days. Why Alexandra Arp spent the night getting ready for the morning commute to class.
I'll warm up my car and drive extra slow, so give myself an extra half an hour to an hour.
LIRR passengers planning an early start too. Trains are operating on a regular schedule tomorrow, but snow on tracks like this at the Seaford station could mean delays.
I think it's going to be really crowded, the trains, and it's going to take a long time in the morning, a little extra just to get through the snow, and it's bitter cold out.
You got to take it as it comes, I guess.
Especially if you get an unexpected call from an expecting father who was stranded in a car on Northern Boulevard during the blizzard. Ambulance technician Larry Loisel answered it and talked the new dad through delivering a healthy baby boy.
I instructed him to take his jacket off, clean the child as best as he could and keep the child warm and turn the heat up in the car so the child didn't get too cold.
That bitter cold is hanging around, creating slippery conditions. We spotted several salt and plow trucks prepping for the big day back to normal. At least as normal as possible, but officials here in Nassau County warn there could be patches of black ice in several places tomorrow, so definitely build in that extra time for your commute. We're live in Massapequa. Weijia Jiang, CBS 2 News.
Weijia, thank you.